So here's the thing about Resident Evil Resistance. I like it, I think, but it's not a good game. It's not very good at all. But I have been playing it a lot. So I can assume, I can only assume that I like it. It's that asynchronous multiplayer mode that was sort of tacked on to the end of Resident Evil 3. And tacked on is certainly how it feels. It's very throwaway, very disposable, but it's not unfun. So as I said, it's asynchronous. Four players will play survivors trying to make their way out of some twisted hellhole full of zombies and monsters. And a fifth player is the Mastermind, an antagonistic figure from the Resident Evil series, be it Annette Birkin or Alex Wesker or Spencer, you know, one of these characters, all of which are incredibly hammy in this. Chew the scenery, constantly shout threats and boasts at the survivor players, which is quite fun. Each one of the masterminds has their own set of weaknesses and strengths and their own specific bioweapon. Annette Birkin, of course, has William Birkin as basically the ultimate trick they have up their sleeve, and if they can deploy that at the absolute worst moment, it can really fuck with the survivors. In fact, fucking with the survivors is pretty much the only job of the Mastermind. This is one big long griefing session for them, as near as I can tell. As a survivor, your job is to have a really bad time. Sometimes in a good way, sometimes in just a genuinely having a bad time kind of way. Survival is stressful for any of the players portraying the protagonist side. Not only do they have to contend with the durable zombies that we've seen since the Resident Evil 2 remake, they have to deal with other bioweapons as well, like the, you know, the warty plant monsters, the ivies, and the, what else, dogs. Dogs are really fucking annoying, they're everywhere. And it can get really stressful, because not only are you on a really harsh time limit with quite limited resources in terms of ammunition and whatnot, and the credits you can find and earn to spend on getting more resources, absolutely every bad thing that happens to you also comes with a time penalty. You get grabbed and bitten by a zombie, not only do you lose time from that, but you get bitten by the zombie and then you'll lose several seconds as well. And that all adds up. Basically, when the survivor team is having a bad time, it can only get worse for them. And in many ways, that is how it should be. This is a survival horror game after all. As the human protagonists, as the survivors, your job is to feel like you're under the cosh and that you are just barely surviving. And when Resident Evil Resistance actually nails that, it's great. It actually feels how it should, like you're just about scraping through. However, when things go south, it often feels like the Mastermind has all of the advantages in the world. I mean, not only can they lay traps everywhere, spawn monsters, all of those things come with their own associated time penalties if they get you. Sometimes they can just take control of any of the cameras in the map, point it at you, and then just shoot you, which 9 times out of 10 is them just awarding themselves free damage off the back of whoever's caught in the sight. This isn't to say things are impossible for the survivors. In the first couple of games, it was all in favor of the Mastermind. Don't worry, we'll talk about playing as the Mastermind in a bit. But the more I've played, the more I've gotten used to the maps, the more I've, the more that everyone playing it has gotten used to playing it, and gotten to work together as a team, now the odds are more 50-50. Each survivor has their own skill set. Becca, for example, is really good with firearms and she can activate a special ability that gives her unlimited ammo. My main character, Valerie, can drop a healing area of effect. January can hack the cameras that the Mastermind uses to spy on and fuck with the survivors, and can also at times increase the cost of the Mastermind's abilities. And then there are the three characters I don't actually play. One of them's good with traps. I think one of them can hit things better, like melee attacks. Each game is divided into three separate maps, and the survivors have to, again, with quite a strict time limit, get to the exit. They can't just run from A to B, however. The main exit of each map is locked until the team performs a specific task. Either they're running around the map gathering key items, and when they've collected all of them, the exit will open, or they've got to run around and find a security zombie who's heavily armored except for their head, kill them, grab a key off that, then run around the map going to various stations to use the key, you know, hack into the mainframe sequence, the genome, etc. And it all culminates in a map where the players have to find three bio things. It's Resident Evil, you just whack the word bio on the beginning of stuff and then you've made a thing. You gotta run around shooting three bio things, then head to the exit and wait for it to open and hold out for one last bit before you get to fuck off. That is, of course, unless you've been swamped with zombies and dogs and William Birkin or Mr. X first. And like I said, when it works, it's quite fun. When it doesn't, it's just annoying. That's a problem any horror game has. You've got to find that balance between scaring the player and then just making the player annoyed. Mr. X is scary until he gets in your way all of the time, and then he's not scary, he's just a pest. But anyway, that's the survivors. You'll be wanting to know how the Mastermind plays. Well, here's some footage of Mastermind play in action. That's literally been my experience since I started playing the game. I tried, Lord knows I tried. Don't think I didn't try to get a game in as the Mastermind, because, you know, that would have been nice for this video, wouldn't it? But I've been playing Resident Evil Resistance since before launch, and I played it all fucking day long yesterday and couldn't get into a game. That's not an atypical situation where I showed the matchmaking going on forever. That is every time I have literally been unable to play as the Mastermind. And that's a problem, not just for Resident Evil Resistance, but all of these asynchronous multiplayer games that are becoming more and more popular. You'll hear similar reports from people. In fact, I checked on Twitter this morning because I was complaining about this. You'll see similar reports from fans of the Friday the 13th game, Dead by Daylight, you know, the five players that play Devolve. They have similar stories where it just takes so long to play as the antagonist, because if you're playing Friday the 13th, everyone wants to play as Jason. If you're playing Resident Evil Resistance, it would appear everyone wants to be Birkin, Wesker, Spencer, whoever. And that is an issue because each game has five players, and the most popular role is the one that only has one slot per game. So it's not surprising that, and I say this as someone who doesn't even like playing the antagonist much. Apparently I'm in a massive minority who generally plays the protagonists, the victims, the survivors, the what have you. But it would be nice, and it would have been nice to have played a Mastermind game, but I don't have that much time. Like, I've got enough time to play this all day so I could do a video for you, but not enough time to then extend what a day is. I can't put more than 24 hours in a day. In fact, I didn't put that original 24 there. I don't get to decide what a day is, you know? So I tried, and I can't. And it seems that asynchronous multiplayer games are getting more and more popular. Friday the 13th was successful, of course, and it's not a brand new concept, but between that and this and Doom Eternal's battle mode and the upcoming Predator game, which, by the way, I played the beta of that, couldn't get into a fucking Predator game either. They're gonna have to find some way to make playing as the survivors, as the human characters in all of these games, fun. and not just like a harassment simulator, because I think that's what turns a lot of people off, is that feeling that you're just being constantly harangued. And for a lot of people, that's not fun. I'm not surprised that some people are joining these games, finding they can't be the mastermind, and then fucking off. I mean, you'd think they could be a little bit more civic-minded, but there you go. That's something this industry is going to have to look at, because this industry is really, really interested in these sorts of games now. Now that, you know, the mainstream industry has seen they're successful and now they want a piece of the action. And they're going to have to make it fun for everyone, no matter the role, because things like this will keep happening. You know, literally haven't gotten one game as a mastermind.
Oh, and it has loot boxes. Fuck that shit.